People who fly quite a bit, comedian Aaron Berg, podcast power puncher Tudor Dixon, and Charles McBee, a comedian, who's also the only black man who's ever asked to borrow my white Bronco. How about that? I likes talking to cops on the side of the highway. It's Charles McBee.
I need an alibi.
You guys look great. How about it?
Let's this talk. Is amazing. I didn't know we were going to go over the reenactment of the O.J. Simpson
thing. It's like, bad news for you, Tudor, you're playing Nicole. Now, as you know, you've seen a little bit of the show. This is not a very political show. But a lot happened in politics this week. For instance, Donald Trump.
Little Joe Biden.
Pimp. Who's warning you that these girls don't have the cleanest bill of health?
I read that book. It was Neil Strauss, The Game, where they really focus on the negative of women, lower their self-esteem, and then get them back. There's nothing bad I can say to you.
Do you have anything to add as a woman no one should mess with?
I think that Jill obviously has control of Joe Biden, and he's scared of her. He should be, you know?
He's a little frightened
of her. Or maybe it's Kamala. Obviously, it's Kamala.
Well, Charles, you like getting yelled at by old white ladies. So
that's true.
What do you add to this?
It's a kink.
I'm concerned, but moving on, okay? I'm not here to bag on Biden, because we can't pretend Trump threw a perfect game this week. Big Don referred to names. But the Barbie backlash shows you just how much social media has broken society's compass and taught us to focus on things that don't keep up with the group.
I've already won that award.
What is going on with this faux Oscar injustice charade? Like, you get paid. You remember when you used to play pretend in the backyard?
Yeah.
You played two games, Cowboys and Elizabeth Warrens. And I can't. You played Cops and Robbers, Cowboys and Elizabeth Warrens. Nobody expected a trophy at the end, let alone a $30 million payday. Okay, the idea that we should be prioritizing this, doesn't that speak to a society losing its way?
We were both actors when we were younger. Charles, have you dabbled?
I've dabbled.
Yeah.
I've dabbled.
We used to all dream of getting the trophy, but now it's just changed because of DEI and stuff. So I'm hoping one day, when I portray Oprah Winfrey, I win a trophy.
You actually have a better shot at getting the Oprah gig, because you could say you were transracial.
Yeah.
Like, Charles can't get it.
No.
It couldn't be Oprah.
It's a wrap for me.
I have a better shot at Oprah than you do.
I think that we should all be concerned about whether or not we can fly with people who are, I don't know, chosen based on whether or not they check the box, and they don't know. Like, when I walk on the airplane and they're drinking and they're partying, I'm like, I feel good. These are the old pilots.
Yeah.
You know, when I have the new pilots, I just don't know if I can.
No, doesn't it make you nervous, McBee? And we've been on the worst flight ever.
Ever.
Okay, all right, really quick. Me and McBee were on a flight to Vegas.
Yeah.
We hit comical turbulence. Not the plane's going down. It's going to disintegrate in midair. We had a pilot with a stutter.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm all for anybody who's trying to overcome a disability, but not at 37,000 feet.
And now when you're talking to us over an airplane during turbulence, I don't want to hear that.
Yeah, we don't want to hear it. You know what I mean?
The old pill-popping drunks, the red-eyed guys.
That's right. That's what I mean.
Barely eking to work.
Yeah, I saw him at the bar ahead of time, I know he can fly the plane.
Yeah.
Like, I feel good about that.
I support pride, but I don't need to see it on the cockpit.
So get rid of DEI, replace it with DUI.
Now it's make flying fun again. All right, now that you're warmed up and feeling fine, let's get the show on the road panel. I'll see you guys on the couch, because they didn't use that graphic for Dana Perino or Bill Hemmer. You got that kind of heat.
They use it for
in the morning. What is Larry Kudlow's go-to order?
Which item?
Easy. It's wild.
You put the peanut butter on the banana and sip the Diet Coke, and you're in business.
And I love this, and now I know why you look so good in the 80s.
Very, very different. I loved working for Donald Trump. The Wall Street thing in the 80s, it was what it was.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of good things that went on there.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, some of those good things went. Stearns was a good place. A lot of smart people.
I bet it was.
I know. Just with a few changes.
Yeah, Larry, you got this. Lena Kudlow plays.
It's not over yet. Trump, by the way, is not a bad tennis player. Better golfer.
I was told he's a solid athlete. Okay, two presidents you worked for, though. You worked in the Reagan
administration. Big God. That's where he draws
the
line.
You just answered that, Kudlow.
I will. By the way, as much as we love you, pretty much everybody.
And a big booster of everything I do here at Fox. I owe you big.
No, you are terrific.
Yes, you are. And we love you for it. The great Larry Kudlow. But in Portland, no one can drop their kids off at a daycare because they all live in the car. Have you been to Portland? You've driven to Portland?
Mary's tent and heroin place.
Tudor Dixon for the win, the clubhouse. in Dallas, Texas. The clubhouse.
The clubhouse. Oh, gosh.
Chance to put it away.
Rich men going secret places. Got to call it the clubhouse because it sounds like you're going golfing. The clubhouse is a strip club.
Till they go wild. Congratulations. Do you have the name of a strip club you'd like a buffet voucher from? I mean, listen, if you're trying to lose weight for TV like I am, a strip club buffet is a great place to eat.
You know? Let me eat for free at work.
Tudor Dixon, on account of you winning the inaugural episode of Strip Club or Daycare, we are presenting you with the yellow jacket.
Amazing.
Tudor Dixon. And they basically said because they wanted to cover that hideous pink. I kid. We love you, Tudor Dixon.
Awesome.
Put it on, girlfriend.
Let me get it on here.
There it is.
Goes well with
just, does it not look at us? Look at us. Look at us. Does it not look amazing by all?
This is like very pretty woman.
Yeah, it's a hot look. It's 2024. It's now pretty person.
That's right.
Yeah, you can't assume gender's pronouns. Amazing work by everybody. Okay, good. Well, I wanted to have a conversation with you.
Okay.
And to be clear, Travis Kelce, Jason Kelce podcast.
New Heights podcast.
And you consider it really good, right?
It's very good.
Another way where there was hanging pineapple flags upside down. Well, we love to do this with couples. Yeah.
Travis, call me. Actually, Jason's, you already got his shirt off. We're halfway there with Jason Kelce. You already took a shirt off in public.
That's a really terrible answer she gave. She's like, I'm so much hotter than you, Jimmy. I don't want people to get the wrong impression.
What's it like being married to Chubarachi?
at the wedding, the organist actually played Here Comes the Pizza Guy. Who ordered Domino's?
We have met, and they seem to be going.
And some of the best advice this is serious, though. You would give to people is, and I mean this though, is if you're trying to start a family with somebody, it does help if they have a relationship with their family.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So I shouldn't.
I really need to put my feet up on this couch.
So I shouldn't exclusively date girls with daddy issues.
Just not with puff daddy issues.
Puff daddy issues. That makes fun. And I would say though, because sometimes you don't have enough people to hate, and it does change style when you move to New York from Ohio.
I did.
So this is where she knows this is coming. Jenny, when you used to get in the best way. In the best way. So Jenny, the verdict is, will it work for Travis and Taylor?
I think so.